Hey everybody, this is Ori from AstroWeb, and today I'm going to talk to you about draft orders, Shopify's draft orders. So what is a draft order, first of all? So a regular order is where a customer goes to your website. For example, this is your site. They add a product to cart, they log in, they check out, they pay. That's a regular order. A draft order is an order that's created by the business, and the business will actually create the order and initiate it, and then the collection of the money, the actual funds for that order, can be in different ways. Either it's paid offline, not related to the website. For example, someone wire transfers, or it's a business payment or something like that. Or the business can actually request money from the customer to pay it. So again, a regular order is customer goes to the website, buys themselves. It's all self-service. And a draft order is the business is opening the order. So why would the business open an order? For example, there's a few reasons. Number one, the customer has an issue with checking out and they literally call or chat with the customer service and then they ask them to create an order. That's number one. Number two is maybe you have a certain business type that the business has to create the orders in the backend. For example, certain B2B, some business to business businesses, they need to require these kind of things, or maybe a salesperson from a B2B business might create the orders on behalf of the customer and then send the invoices, things like that. So this video is here to show you how do you use draft orders, what can you do, and I'm going to walk you through. And of course, if you have any questions, comments, then I'll be happy to answer. Okay, so first of all, I logged into my demo store and I went to the back end to orders, and here's the, under orders, you can see all of your orders, but right below there's a draft, okay? So in the drafts, you'll be able to see a very familiar section with the list and filtering, all of these things. So you'll be able to see orders that are open, completed, paid for, invoiced, etc. And we'll talk about these statuses a little bit later. So let's say a customer called me for customer service and they couldn't check out. Maybe they were having some bugs or they don't know how to use the website or something like that. So they would call me and say, okay, I want to create this order. So I would click here on create order. And now I need to fill in my shopping cart and my information. So the first thing usually I like to do is actually create the customer right here. You can go in any order you want, it's okay, but I like to create the customer here. So first of all, if I already have the customers here, that they're already a customer in my account, they've already registered before, I can actually go and find them. So I find them, for example, May, and I can actually search for them and all of, and click on it, right? So if I click on it, for example, it'll fill in their default address, their name, their email. It'll show me if they've ordered before and their default shipping address. If their default shipping address is different from the new address they want to ship to, I can click on edit, I can fill this in, et cetera. I can do all of these things, okay? And if the billing address is different, I can edit this. Perfect. After I do that, okay, and another thing is if I don't want to use that and if it's a new customer, I can click on X here and I can click here, create a new customer, and I can fill in all of their information right here. Right, their address, do they want to accept email marketing, and of course their email and their name. But basically once you fill that out, it'll look the same. So let's say I selected May, okay? And now what I want to do is I want to select the products that they want to buy. So I can go here, I can click on browse, I can either search or I can go here and use these filters, for example, certain collections, etc. Now let's say I want to, I'm going to add a few products. So I'm going to add this and I'm going to add, let's see what other products I have here. Let's just say this product. So I'm going to add, now I have two products added. Okay, so you can adjust the quantity, you can adjust the pricing. Sorry, let me slow down. So you can adjust the quantity, for example, two here. You can actually, you're seeing it updated. You can actually adjust the discount. For example, it's I want to discount it by $10 so they get a different price and I can specify the reason. For example, I don't know, holiday discount. Okay. Okay. So I added discount. What else can I do? Right. I can add it right here. I can give other discounts also by percentage, for example, 50% off, and I can explain why it is maybe a loyalty discount or something like that. Okay. I can remove them easily, etc. And I can add a note. I can add a note. For example, customer wants to deliver, this is an order note between, let's say, 2 and 4 p.m. Okay, so I can click here. Now, what else can I do? I can add a custom item. So if the item is not in my catalog right here, I can add a custom item. For example, they want a gift, they want, let's say, a card, like a birthday card, let's just say, okay? And their price, let's say I'm gonna charge them $2, and is it taxable and require shipping? For sure, yes. Okay, so I can do that. Okay, so now I add another product, I can have it right here. What else can we do? We can add a discount to the whole cart instead of adding a discount per line item. So I can do this, and I can discount, for example, everything by, let's say, 90%, okay? And I can also add shipping. Okay, now I already have the auto-calculated shipping rates that are in my settings calculation. Why? Because I already have my products and I already have a shipping address. If you don't have a shipping address and you actually selected products first, then you wouldn't have this. You would basically only have the free shipping if you set up free shipping or custom, which you can make your own, right? For example, I'm going to use DHL in this case, and it'll cost a flat $4. I can do that as well. Now, the reason I like to put the customer first is because of this reason, right? And then taxes, I can charge taxes or not charge taxes. And if I do click on charge, it'll use my settings for my taxes. Okay, once I do this, I have a few options. Number one, I can save the draft order, or I can actually go ahead to process it for payment. So I'm gonna click on save draft order, but you don't have to do this. So you can do any step that you want, but I'm just gonna save it for a second, okay? So when I clicked on save draft order, it's right here, right? It has the order notes. It's in the draft order. It's not an order yet, right? You see draft order is D23. This is the ID, for example. If I go here to orders, it is not there, okay? So how do I get it to be an actual order? What options do we have right now? So I'm gonna click here, okay? And if you notice, let me go back one page. If you notice, this order has a status and it's called opened, which means that the draft order was opened, but nothing happened. No one paid for it. It wasn't delivered. It wasn't actually created as a real order, etc. So I'm going to click here. And what can I do? You can do a few things. Number one is you have, these are the options of the next step. So number one is if you want the customer to actually pay for it, you want them to go to the website to pay, you would click here on email invoice. Okay, this is option number one. What is that gonna do? That is actually gonna go, I'm gonna email it to myself. Okay, it automatically fills, and this is a payment request. Okay, so what is actually happening? You can also CC it to yourself. You're gonna send an email to the customer to tell them, okay, you have this stuff, a draft order was created, click here to pay. And when they click here, they're going to go to the checkout page and they can pay themselves. So if I click here, I can review the email one more time. This is how it looks. Uses the template itself. And I'm going to click on send notification. Once I do that, an email is going to be sent to the customer right here. Okay. And if you click on draft, now the status changed to invoice sent. So now I know it was opened and I've already requested the customer to pay. And what's going to happen? Let me go here. I'm going to search. And you see in my email, I have a D23. This is my email. And it says, hey, please complete your order. This is what's in your product. These are all the discounts and all these nice things. You also got the birthday card. And they click. So if I click here, it's going to take me to the checkout page immediately. You don't have to go to the website and log in and do any of these things. Okay? So now I can go. Here's my payment and my shipping method, excuse me. And I can go and just create an order. So for example, I click here. Now, one more thing before I rush to the next step. Right here, every time the draft order gets some kind of update, it'll be documented here in the timeline right here. So you created a draft order, etc. Now, a real order was not created until I pay. So I'm going to make a payment. This is my temp. This is my kind of fake payment gateway. Okay. And I'm going to go here and I'm going to click on pay. Once I did this, an order is going to be created. Okay, so we're going to see in a few seconds. Okay, so I got the order. Great. Now if I go here and I go back to drafts, I'm going to click on it right here. It is completed. Why is it completed? Because the order was made and someone paid. If I go to my timeline below, You'll be able to see the draft order was created, the invoice was sent, and then an order, this order number 1056, was created. So if I go here to orders, 1056 will be created right there. It was paid for, because obviously I paid. It was paid, not fulfilled yet, of course. And if I go down to the timeline of the regular orders, you'll be able to see that it came from draft D23. So both the draft order and the real order are connected via these IDs, right? A draft starts with a D, and then regular order starts with a number. So that's great. So now it was created, and of course, the customer got, just like a normal order, the customer got an order. So I'm going to click here, the order, here it is, and then the customer got their orders. Okay, great. I'm going to click here. So what else can we do for draft orders? Let's create another one. Click here, create order, and it select May again. Okay, and I'm going to keep the same everything, and I'm actually going to browse, going to select a different product. Let's just say this one. Okay, so I selected it. I'm not going to override anything for this part. And instead of emailing and asking them to do it, I can do three other things. There's three other options. First of all, I can actually mark it as paid, pending, or credit card. So what does that mean? So first of all, if the customer doesn't know how to check out, or I don't want to send them an invoice so they can click on the link and then buy, I can also accept a credit card by phone. So if they call me and they don't know how to check out, I click here, I create my order, and then you see the pay by credit card is here. And so I can go ahead and put their credit card, for example, just whatever their number is, right? Etc. Okay, I can type it in and I can fill it out. And if everything's good, I will charge it. The order will be created, etc. So I have a fake gateway, so I can actually create this order. Okay, this is for a test site only, right? Okay, and I'm going to click and I created the order. So let's see. I can go here, it's processing and it's using the Shopify Pay in this case to actually create the backend order, the draft order. So now you go here and you see I have a 1057, the order was created, it was created from a draft order, it was paid for, etc. Okay, so let's go to draft, and draft should be completed as well. So one thing about receiving the backend payment, receiving a credit card, depending on what your company policy is and your PCI compliance, the way you comply with the credit card standards, you may or may not want to accept credit cards over the phone because that might be a security issue. That is up to your business specific part to decide. But this option is available, and it's available for, you know, draft orders. Pretty useful, but you need to consult with your business requirements and legal, et cetera, so you stay PCI compliant and you follow the guidelines of your company. So let's create another one. We're almost finished. We have a few more things we can do here. So let's create a draft order. Okay, and what else can we do? I'm going to go ahead and select May again. Okay, and I'm going to select the product. Let's just say here, product, and I selected these two products. Okay, now what else can I do? So let's say that I actually want to accept money, not via Shopify, not via an invoice, them clicking and checking out, or me collecting credit card. I want to accept it otherwise. So for example, if I'm a B2B business, or I accept a payment on delivery or something like that, what I can do is I can mark these as different statuses. So first of all, if I haven't received a payment, for example, payment on delivery, I would click here on mark as pending. What does that mean? Okay, so first of all, an order is going to be created. Okay, so one more step actually before the order gets created. Depending on what settings you have here, what other types of payments you have, for example, cash on delivery, you'd have to actually click here and say, this is the payment type I'm going to accept. After the order is created, I'm going to use this. So now, if I go here, you see the order is going to be created. Let me go here, orders. Okay, and it is pending. So the order was created 1058. It was created from the draft, from draft 25. And it's right here. And just like we process normal orders with payment on delivery or other cash deliveries afterwards, once I deliver it, I would, you know, I would click my shipping label, I would deliver it. once it's delivered, I would actually go ahead and mark it as paid for. So let's create a shipping label, for example, and show you a really basic flow. Let's say I have cash on delivery. I would go to my whatever company it would be, okay? And I would go here and, oh, actually, I don't want to create a shipping label because I made just a very sample product. So I want to kind of skip this, but I'll show you how it works. Okay, so let's say I went ahead and I fulfilled it, and this is just products that are demo. That's why I received all of these errors there. So let's say I fulfilled it. I go ahead to fulfill it. I'll put some tracking number. Let's say, you know, let's say DHL, for example. Okay, I put the tracking number, and I fulfill the items. Okay, once I fulfilled it, the person, that is delivery man that's actually collecting money, once they collect the money, they're going to notify me, and then I click here on mark as paid. And when I do that, I actually got the money and I keep it for my records. And then my order is complete. It was fulfilled and paid for, just like a normal order. Okay. But the flow, the business flow, was a little different. Okay. And the last one, which is really similar, if I create a draft order here, click on May. And one second. Okay. So I click here, and the last thing I can do actually is click on mark as paid. It's the same as mark as pending, but basically it'll mark as pending and immediately go to paid. So it's kind of stepping the other way. So for example, if I'm a B2B business, okay, and let's say I had other, okay, and they wire transferred to me some funds before the order was actually shipped and created. Once I know I collected it, I can create this draft order and mark it as paid. So it's kind of like skipping that other thing. So you see here, order 59 was created. It was created obviously from the draft, etc. So I finished it. The last things I want to show about this video, okay, on this video, is when I create an order, I can actually add tags to the order. Okay, so for example, I'm going to click on May. And I'm going to select some product. Okay, and let's just say I marked it. So this is the tags. So if I want to organize it in a way that makes sense, I can, for example, call this wholesale drafts, or I can call it B2B, or I can call it, you know, other type, whatever organization I want to call it, or how to manage and organize these things, I can put it here. So I'm going to click on save draft order. And these tags can help me actually sort through things. So if I have a lot of draft orders and I want to filter them, I can actually organize them in ways to see them better here. And with filters, obviously, you can always, for example, I can filter them by wholesale backend orders. So here. Okay, I'm going to click here. And let me see here. Go back. Usually when you make tags, it takes a few seconds. So let me undo this, go back, and check my, okay, wholesale, good. I'm going to go back to drafts. Usually takes like 20 or 30 seconds for it. I'm going to go here to tags, wholesale. Okay, and here it goes, right? So sometimes it takes time when you create a new tag. Okay, and then I can actually save it. I can save it. For example, I want to call it wholesale. If I save the filters, it will always be right here, so I can easily access it and organize my system. In addition, you can export the draft. You can export the draft orders for your organization. And if you have any apps, you can do other things with them. So that's basically the idea. Draft orders, just to summarize, are ways for the business to create the orders for the customers, instead of the normal orders, which the customers use the self-service website to do themselves. There's ways to track it. It's really good for B2B businesses. It's good for cash on delivery, all of this stuff. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to, last thing, if you want to set up cash on delivery, you can basically go to your store settings, click on shipping, and create your own delivery methods. But that's it. It's really, really simple. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, let me know. I'll be happy to answer. Thank you guys for your time. Always appreciate it.